I'm Sarah. I'm on most parts of the internet as PhDancer's Teapot, and I'm just here today to tell you a bit about stuff that I create. I had an intro video on my Patreon until now that was getting kind of old and I didn't really look like I look now, and some of it wasn't quite relevant anymore. So this is partly to update that and partly to give me something to put on YouTube as a kind of introduction to all the stuff that I do. So what do I make? I am, for the most part, a writer-illustrator. The main writing that I do is the monthly Storytime for Grown-Ups project, and that's the main thing that my Patreon funds, that patrons are part of. I also do some illustration of those stories, and I do some other visual artwork as well. I do some photography and little bits of filmmaking, and a big part of what I do now has become this virtual curation stuff, where I try and bring together different creatives from all around the world to create video projects with contributions from different kinds of artists. So a lot of this stuff is stuff that I just do for free to try and support other creatives, or because it really is my passion, and that's the case with the novel that I'm writing, which is in the editing stage at the moment. So what's this Patreon thing? Patreon is a kind of crowdfunded version of what in the olden days happened, where a rich patron would fund somebody like Shakespeare to produce their work because they wanted to see that finished work. And then other people got to benefit as well because they got to see the plays too. So when you've got a creator who's doing stuff just for free, this is a way for them to get an income, but instead of it coming from one very rich person, lots of people can give a small amount per month, and that can form an income for that person to keep doing the things that they do. The main thing that I do for my Patreon is the Storytime for Grown-Ups. My patrons are all invited to come along and be on-screen listeners to Storytime. At the moment, most of them do choose to do that. You don't have to do that if you don't want to be in my recordings of the stories. But it's a really wonderful community that we have around Storytime. I think everybody looks forward to seeing each other and that social element of it, as well as to the stories themselves. At the end of each year of Storytime, I type all of those up and create a self-published collection with an illustration for every story and a nice illustrated cover and everything. And I try to get those out to patrons and other supporters as well. But that is not cheap to do. So the Patreon partly funds me making those books. Patrons and other supporters also request the topics that I will write about in the next story time during each session, so you get some say in that. Patrons also get access to a patron-only feed on Patreon, where I usually give you access to drafts and behind-the-scenes information. So I try to do semi-regular posts there, and some of my novel drafts and early in plans for things and stuff like that will be shown there if you're interested in seeing a bit behind the scenes. If you want to be a patron and help to give me an income for the stuff I do, you can go to patreon.com/phdancersteapot and you can pick a tier, or you can nominate an amount to give each month. If you're not able to do that, you can still support Storytime and you can be part of it. To support Storytime in a more general way, all I need from you is to share some of my videos, share about the stuff that I'm doing, and try and encourage more people to know about it and get involved. On my YouTube, you'll find various things. One of the things you will find is the recordings of the monthly story times. There's a playlist with every story time since the very beginning of this project, and you can listen to all of those stories. You'll also find all the virtual exhibitions that I've done so far. There's a playlist of those that you can have a look to see the kinds of things I've put together with other creators. I sometimes do small documentary type things, such as diaries of moving to the UK. I'm originally from Australia, so I'm an expat now living in Sheffield. And just sort of poetry videos, nature things. A very long way back, you'll find me dancing, which is obviously the origin of the dancer in PhDancer's Teapot. So in what seems like another life now, I did do a PhD. It was in cognitive psychology, I did research on recognition memory very long time ago now. You can ask me about it if you like, but I may not remember all that much. It's been a lot of years. At the time when I was doing my PhD, the main creative thing that I did was dance. I was an Irish dancer and did a little bit of ballet and a bunch of little bits of other things. So that was kind of the core couple of bits to what I saw as what I did at the time. And then down the track, when I became more focused on my writing and illustration, that name on its own became less relevant. So I wanted to add something that was more about the storytelling, the community created around stories and creative work, imagination, that sort of thing. And for me, tea is something that links me to my ancestors. My grandma was really the source of tea loving in my family. It's also something that is about community. We share tea with people who we form community and with and who we care about. And it has that element of inspiring the imagination, of maybe reading tea leaves and there being some mystical sort of elements about it. So that's where the teapot came from, and I added that on the end a couple of years ago to kind of distinguish now from the past and to make it a little bit more relevant and specific. You'll see me with tea all the time. It's a big part of my life. I strongly encourage the consumption of tea during story times and enjoying it as part of appreciating any of the creative outputs that I make. So bring your cuppa along, and I hope you find something you enjoy on my channel, or in general on my social media and other places I post creative work.